Hello dear students of class 8. Now we are going to start the next topic of second chapter, that is density. Mainly the density in this second chapter we have to study. We have to measure the substances of density. We had studied in first lecture, first video, that what is density, how to find the density of a solid substance. In second video we have studied the density of finding liquids, that is fluid, by using measuring cylinder, beam balance and density bottle. Now we are going to move to the next topic, that is relative density, RD. Relative density. First of all, there should be a question in our mind that why it is a need of relative density. What is relative density? Okay. For learning or remembering the density of substances, as we have many substances, we have found 128 to 150 elements. And to remember each and each element's density is becomes tough. That's why scientists decided that we will find the density with respect to water, as water present everywhere in this universe, in this earth. Okay, on this earth, is it easy to find water? That's why they started comparing the density of any substances with the density of water. Okay, it is easy. That's why they took water as a next substance. Okay, so first of all, here we are going to start, what is relative density? Relative density of a substance is defined as the ratio of the density of the substance to the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. In this definition, it has mentioned 4 degrees Celsius, which we will learn in next topic, the anomalous behavior of water, in which we find that the density of water will increase or decrease depends on the temperature. Okay. That's why, and with the decrease of density, with the decrease of temperature, the density of substance should increase, but it is not with the water. As the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius is maximum, after lowering the temperature from 4 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius, when water convert into ice, its density decrease. It should increase. As when we lower the temperature of any substance, the density should increase. But the density of water decreases. That's why it is called as anomalous behavior of water, which we learn in the next topic. Okay, that's why scientists took the temperature, that is 4 degrees Celsius, at which the density of water is maximum. Above the 4 degrees Celsius, below the 4 degrees Celsius, the density of water decrease. Okay, at 4 degrees Celsius, it is maximum. That's why they took the 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, so what is the relative density? Relative density of a substance is defined as the ratio of the density of the substance to the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. It is also known as specific gravity. It is by another name, it is also known as, that is specific gravity. There is no relation with the gravity, that is the acceleration due to gravity or gravity. There is no relation, it's the name only, specific gravity. Okay. Come to the next point. As it is a ratio, so it has no unit. means that relative density has no unit, because relative density is the quantity which is the ratio of density of two substances. Means density and density, that's why the unit of density is cancelled out and it is becomes a number. Okay, so relative density, density of substance by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. For example, here come to the point, next example, as we have taken the example that density of aluminium is 2700 kg per meter cube. Here I have taken Al. Al is a stand for aluminium, its atomic name, short name, that is Al, symbol of aluminium. Rho we have taken as the symbol of density. So density of aluminium is 2700 kg per meter cube, while density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. So I have to find the density of aluminium. That's why I have divided the density of aluminium with the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. Okay. Since the density of water at 4 degrees Celsius in CGS unit 1 gram per centimeter cube, and a standard unit, SI unit, it is 1000 kg per meter cube. So I have taken 1000 kg per meter cube. The kg meter, kg per meter cube and kg per meter cube will cancel out and it will give a number, a fraction, a digit, that is 2.7. Means 2.7 is the relative density of aluminium. Okay. Now come to the next point, which is also related with the relative density. It means the another definition of relative density is here. If we take equal volume of substances and water, H2O, water, H2O is the symbol of water, a chemical formula which I am representing here, H2O. If we take a substance which have some volume, a certain volume, and water of same volume, if we take equal volumes of substance and water, okay, then relative density, as we know the density of substance by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius, we already studied that density of substance is mass by volume of the substance, mass of by volume of the substance. So density of substance is mass of substance divided by volume of substance. Okay. Next, density of water, also there should be a formula, mass of water divided by mass of volume of water. Okay. So as we have taken the volume of substance and volume of water is same, that's why we will cancel the volume of substance here. The remaining thing is mass of certain volume of substance divided by mass of equal volume of water. This is the another definition of relative density. Relative density is also defined as mass of certain volume of substance by mass of equal volume of water. Means that if you are taking 5 meter cube volume of any substance, and of same volume, means 5 meter cube of water also you are taking, and dividing both the substances and the volume of mass of water, you will get the relative density of that substance. So it is an important point here. The relative density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube, and relative density of water is in a standard unit 1000 kg per meter cube. Okay, it should be always with your mind. You have to note it. At 4 degrees Celsius, it is a standard value. Why it is at a standard value at 4 degrees Celsius, I have explained you. Okay, so I thought that you may be able to understand. If any problem, please ask during the class, message me. Whatever you face the problem. Okay, bye. Thank you.